Dumoulin can't hold the puck in. Here come the Canucks. Besser with a chance. Keith scores! Can you believe this? Brock Besser has another one. And the Brock Star gives the Canucks a 1-0 lead.
Anders Nielsen makes a good save on a wraparound try. Carl Hagelin has really struggled. Has just one goal, pulls it out, tries to go high short side. It's stopped. And a rebound is cleared wide. And this is unbelievable. Nice play by Sven Berchi. Feathers it through.
And a different strategy for the Penguins on that breakout. And dump it without Malkin on this power play. It's going to be interesting.
Gensel down the middle. Gensel all alone. He stopped. Rebound. He scores! Power play goal. Jake Gensel's tied this game up at one.
I said it was going to be interesting. I didn't expect it to happen like that. And Jake Gensel, that was the difference on the power play. Without Malkin, how about trying to score on the rush? Bottom left corner of your screen. Now the speed. Now splitting that gap. Getting the shot. Following it up on...
Oh, it gave the puck away. He ran into the broken stick. Here's a rebound attempt. And Erickson scores. What a break for the Canucks. Thomas Vanek got the puck as Kessel stick handled right into the... broken Crosby stick, and Erickson makes it 2-1.
Phil Kessel without Jenny Malkin. And looking around, skates it back into his own zone. Louis Erickson got his empty net goal last night. Gets a one with the goalie in. Thomas Vanek takes advantage. Slides it at Matt Murray. The rebound comes right out to Louis Erickson.
Good patience there. Open up some space. Pouliot with a wrist shot. Deflected in. I think it hit Dumoulin and went in the net. He was battling Vanek. And if it's Derek Pouliot's goal, it's his first with the Canucks. 3-1 on the power play.
Boy, and what a play by Thomas Vanek at the blue line, John. You talked about the patience. And that opened up the ice. Vanek just waited, did a little button hook, and you can see Jacob Markstrom giving him the high sign. Wait. Button hook, little backhand pass or to Pouliot, and then Vanek goes to the net, and that's the reason
for Daniel Sedin. Back to Alex Edler. Henrik Sedin. Looking across towards Besser. Daniel gives it back to Henrik. Here's Edler. Besser, one-timer, scores! What a rocket! Brock Besser, back-to-back two-goal games, and the Canucks are up 4-1.
Can we call that the Ovechkin power play? That's what it is. That's the Washington power play. And the NHL, it's a league of imitators. And when something's successful, like Washington's power play, and you got a shooter like Brock Besser, you can do that. And the Sedins throw it around, open up some ice, so that Besser's got some room for that.
Big opportunity. And Phil Kessel. A lot of space here, inching in, down low, deflection, score! Right in front, looked like Jake Gensel.
And it went off a skate of Jake Gensel right in front. He was right at the hash marks, just inside. And Phil Kessel had backed in everybody off the faceoff win by Crosby. And now you got a chance. There's Gensel right in the middle. Off his
faceoff against Crosby. They tie each other up. Puck comes free to Edler. His clearing attempt was blocked. Quick shot. Knocked down by the glove of Nielsen as Hornquist threw it on goal. That was dangerous. Now here's Gauntz with an empty net. Gets it to Sutter. And Brandon Sutter scores. 5-2 Canucks. Sutter from Gauntz. And Vancouver's going to win another one in Pennsylvania.
And teammates realize Brendan Gauntz hasn't scored in a long time. And that's an unselfish move. He didn't have the clear angle, and he feeds it to Brandon Sutter. Brendan Gauntz hasn't scored in, what, 80 games? Gives it to Sutter.